Hello student, in this video we are going to study regarding plant hormones. So these plant hormones are also known as the phytohormones, as they are present in the plants, where these plant hormones are nothing but the organic compounds which in low concentration control physiological process in the plants. That is, these are required for carrying out different physiological processes in the plants, where these are also called as an intracellular messenger. That is, these are responsible for sending the different messages which are carried out or which are required for the intracellular functioning. Where these are having low molecular weight, and these hormones, they control the complete life cycle of the plant. That is, these are responsible for carrying out the life cycle of the plants. Therefore, these are called as the plant hormones. Where these plant hormones, these are of two types. That is, they are plant growth regulators, where these are native substances or exogenous substances. Where native substances, these are also called as endogenous or plant hormones. That means they are synthesized inside the plant body. So these hormones are not need to be provided externally. Where exogenous substances, which means synthetic growth regulators, where these are required to be provided to the plants externally. Okay, so these are the synthetic one. So these are the two types of growth regulators. Where now we will see regarding the type of the hormones. So the another type of the hormones which are depending on the sources where from which these are obtained. The first one is indole, where indole compounds are derivatives of amino acid like tryptophan, and the example is auxin, where auxin is a major plant growth regulator. The second one, that is purines, where purines are the nitrogenous bases, and this purine derived from the adenine is nothing but cytokine, where these cytokines are also known as a kinetin, and this acts as a promoter. Then the next one, that is terpenes. The terpenes are derived from the lipids, and the example is gibberellin. While the hormone which is derived from the carotenoid, that is nothing but abscisic acid, and these carotenoids are nothing but the pigments. While the last one, that is the gases form, which is nothing but the ethylene, and we know that this ethylene is responsible for ripening of the fruits. Then regarding the functions of the hormones, where as these are the plant hormones, so the function, first function is nothing but it regulate the cell division and enlargement. So it is responsible for causing the division of the cell and also for cell enlargement. The second function is cell differentiation and organogenesis, where the cell differentiation means formation of different cells from single cell. While the organogenesis, it is nothing but synthesis of organ. So genesis is nothing but the formation or a synthesis. So it is nothing but the synthesis of organs like flowers, fruits, leaves, etc. The third function is senescence, which means inhibition of ability to grow. That is, it is responsible for showing or for causing aging in the plants. The fourth function, that is dormancy. So dormancy, it is nothing but the resting stage where the part is unable to grow further. That is, for example, in case of bird, the bird normally develops into a shoots, but in dormancy stage, this bird is unable to develop into a shoot. The next fifth function, that is It is responsible for the ripening of the fruits. Sixth function, that is, it is responsible for plant tissue culturing. So we know that in plant tissue culture, the culturing is carried out by means of using a single tissue of a plant which is developed on the nutrient media for growth or for development of whole plant, where during this growth, whatever the nutrient media provided, it should contain these plant hormones which are responsible for growth, not only the growth, but it is also responsible for organogenesis. Okay, and the last, that is the seventh function, it is nothing but production of secondary metabolites. So as we know, that is, secondary metabolites are responsible for showing the activities, or these are responsible for a therapeutic property. So during these tissue culture techniques, these hormones are generally used to develop a particular type of a secondary metabolite. So this is regarding the general functions of these plant hormones. Now we will see regarding the functions which are specific to a particular hormone. So in case of auxin, this auxin is responsible for support to the plant vertical growth. So it provides support to the vertical growth of a plant. It is also responsible for the cell differentiation that we have already seen, that is, it is responsible for formation of a different cells from a single cell. Then it is also responsible to control the stem elongation, that is, the elongation of a stem between the nodes and the internodes. It is also responsible for apical dominance, that means it causes the growth of the apex portion. So this is the apex portion, and here the general growth will occur because of these auxins, because auxin gets saturated in between this apex portion, and that is responsible for the growth. Then this auxin, it is also responsible for the gravitropism of the root, that is nothing but growth of the root towards the gravity. While the second hormone, which is nothing but cytokinin, and this cytokinin, it is responsible for the lateral bud growth. So this is the lateral bud, and the growth of this lateral bud will occur because of these cytokines. While these cytokines are also responsible for cell division as well as for growth of the fruits. The third hormone, that is the gibberellins, where this gibberellin is again responsible for the stem elongation. The fourth hormone, that is the abscisic acid. So this abscisic acid, it is generally responsible for closing the stomata. That is, this is the structure of the stomata which is having a pore in between these two guard cells. But this abscisic acid, it is responsible for closing this pore in between this guard cell. This generally occurs in a water stress condition, that is, whenever there is a less amount of water is available for the plant, in that cases, to maintain the water level, this abscisic acid, it causes closing of the opening of these two guard cells, and therefore it prevents the water loss. Also, this is responsible for the abscission zone, that it causes the abscission in the plants. Abscission, it is nothing but where the detachment of the different plant parts will occur. So this abscisic acid is responsible for the abscission. While the fifth hormone, that is nothing but the ethylene, and this ethylene, it is generally responsible for ripening of the fruits. Not only that, it is also responsible for causing the abscission in the plant, that is, for causing the detachment of a particular part of the plant. Okay. So next is regarding plant growth promoters. So these plant hormones, these are divided into the plant growth promoters and plant growth inhibitors. So regarding plant growth promoters, so as the name indicate, these are responsible for promoting cell division. These are also responsible for cell enlargement. They causes flowering, fruiting in the plants. Also, these are responsible for the seed promotion. Where the examples of these plant growth promoters are nothing but auxin, gibberellins and cytokines. So you have to remember that is the plant growth promoters are nothing but the auxins, gibberellins and cytokines. While the plant growth inhibitors, that is the functions of these are responsible for the abscission, that is detachment of the plant parts, then senescence, that is it causes aging in the plants, and dormancy, which is nothing but we have seen that is the resting stage where no growth will occur in the plant. For example, in dormancy condition, the seed will not show germination, and in dormancy condition, the bud will not show growth into the shoots. For the examples of this plant growth inhibitors, that is ethylene and abscisic acid. So you have to remember this plant examples of this plant growth inhibitors, that is nothing but ethylene and abscisic acid. So let us start with the first hormone, that is auxin. So it was observed by the Charles and Darwin, that is this auxin, it is generally responsible for causing bending in the plants towards the light. So this observation was carried out by Charles and Darwin, but it was discovered and isolated by Wendt, where this auxin word, it is derived from the Greek word which is having the meaning that is nothing but to grow, where these are indol derivatives which are specifically derived from amino acids, and these auxins are responsible for showing phototropism. Phototropism, that means whenever the plant is grown, so this plant is responsible for bending towards the light, and that bending towards the light, it is known as the phototropism, and auxin is responsible for this. Where the types of the auxins, there are two types, that is natural and synthetic one. Where the natural auxin, it is nothing but indole acetic acid, also known as IAA, and synthetic auxins, these are indole 3-butyric acid, IBA, naphthyl acetic acid, NAA, and 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid, that means 2,4-D. Well, now we will see the general functions of this auxin. So the auxin, it is responsible for stem elongation, where it stimulates the internode elongation and therefore causes the stem elongation. Then it is responsible for apical dominance, that means it is responsible for showing the growth of the lateral buds. Then the third function, that is it promotes abscission, that means it is responsible for detachment of the parts of the plants. Fourth one, that is differentiation of vascular tissues, where xylem and phloem are the vascular tissues in which xylems are present in the form of vessels and the phloem are present in the form of fibers. So the differentiation between these xylem vessels and the phloem fibers is carried out by means of this auxin. The next, it is also responsible for initiation of the root in the stem cutting. So whenever there is a vegetative propagation is carried out, so at that time when stem is used, so in that case the root initiation is carried out by means of this auxin. Not only that, this auxin is also responsible for development of a adventitious root. That means it also shows rooting in other parts of the plant. then it is also responsible for delay in senescence. That means it causes delay in aging of the plants. Whereas this is responsible for showing tropistic response. That means it shows bending in response to the gravity as well as the light, where we have already seen regarding the phototropism, where the plant is having tendency to move or to bend towards the light. So that particular response is shown because of this auxin. Where regarding the applications of these auxins, so as we have seen the functions, so according to that the applications are, that is, it is responsible for vegetative propagation because it shows rooting in stems. Not only that, it is also responsible for showing the rooting in other parts of the plant. That is, it develops adventitious roots also, where the specifically IAA is responsible for this adventitious root development. Then it also shows parthenocarpic root development. That is, the development of the fruit will occur without fertilization, and that is possible only because of this auxin. Then the 2,4-D, that means 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid, it is responsible for showing weedicide property. Here weedicide means the weeds are nothing but the grass or the unwanted plants which are growing in the cultivated area. So these weeds are killed by means of this 2,4-D, where it is also showing the application in the plant tissue culture, like it is used for the formation of a callus, that is, for the development of a mass from the tissue in the nutrient media that can be occur because of these auxins. Not only that, it is also responsible for the root formation in the tissue culture technique. Where the fifth application, that is, it is used for increasing production of secondary metabolites. So for development of a different secondary metabolites can be carried out by means of this auxin, where the two examples are mentioned here, that is, naphthyl acetic acid, it is responsible for increasing the yield of volatile oil content of the Mentha piperata, which is generally occur more than 40% in the normal Mentha piperata. While in case of ergot, it promote the production of the indole acetic acid whenever there is a maximum amount of auxin is present. So this is regarding the applications of the auxins. So the second plant hormone, that is cytokines, where this cyto means cell and kines means division, it means it promote the cell division, or it is responsible for the cell division. So obviously, as it is responsible for the cell division, therefore it is responsible for the development of the buds also. Okay, where the cytokines, these are generally derived from the purines, that is, these are the purine derivatives, and initially these are also called as a kinetin, where the scientists Scook and Miller, they came with the concept of this cytokine. Where the regarding the types, there are two types, that is, natural and synthetic. Where the natural cytokines, it includes the examples like zeatin, N6-dimethylaminopurine, isopentylaminopurine. While in case of synthetic, the examples are kinetin, NN-diphenylurea. So now regarding the functions, so the function, that is, obviously the first function is nothing but the cell division, where as it is responsible for the cell division, it also stimulates the morphogenesis. So genesis is nothing but the formation. So it is responsible for formation of a leaf and stems, etc. Then it is also responsible to stimulate the growth of the lateral bud as well as adventitious buds. So generally it is responsible for the bud development. Then it also causes leaf expansion, it stimulates chlorophyll synthesis, it delays senescence, it develops the embryo during the seed formation, and it is responsible for seed germination, and also it enhances stomatal opening. So these are the functions of the cytokines, where you can see that is these are generally responsible for showing the growth, as well as they promote the growth properties in the plant. While regarding the applications of cytokines, where it induces, obviously it induces the cell division in the plant tissue culture technique, where it is also responsible for the shoot initiation in the tissue culture technique. So during tissue culture technique, from the single tissue or a single cell, the whole plant is developed. So during this, the cytokines which are used in the nutrient media, these are generally responsible for the cell division as well as for the development of shoots. Then it releases of lateral bud dormancy. That means it is responsible for showing the growth of the lateral bud. Then it also increases the growth of the vegetables, and thus it is also responsible for increasing the final yield or increasing the final product formation. Then it is also responsible to inhibit dormancy in the seed. So inhibit the dormancy, that means it is responsible for the seed growth or seed germination. Okay, so here it is responsible for both bud development as well as the seed germination. Then it increases the amount of secondary metabolites whenever there is application of the cytokines in the development of the secondary metabolites. Then it reduces the rate and extent of chlorophyll degradation, as it prevents the degradation of the chlorophyll, as well as it is also responsible for preventing the degradation of the protein also. Okay, so this is regarding the applications of the cytokines. Okay, so cytokines, they generally shows the cell development or the cell growth. So accordingly, these are showing almost the positive responses in case of the plant growth. Okay, that is the formation of the buds, bud development, growth of the seed, development of the secondary metabolite, etc. Okay, so this is regarding the cytokines. Thank you very much. Please like and share this video, and also subscribe my channel to get more videos regarding pharmacognosy subject. Thank you.